It's so hot. 15 miles of golden sands. I've been sunbathing all day.
Is that what it is?
Why, you're dressed like this, like an Eskimo.
Because it's raining, it's cold.
Right, well, welcome anyway to Great Yarmouth. And without more ado, let us welcome the teams. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, first of all, the team of Norwich.
Hey.
And now the team of North Walsham. And listen for this one, the home cheers, the home team, the team of Great Yarmouth.
Well, you know, the favourites are without any doubts.
And now let's go over to game one, because over here we have six conks. On the end here, we've got Great Yarmouth in the middle. We've got Norwich on the end. It is freezing as well, isn't it? And North Walsham. And their job is to go down the course, thank you, bursting balloons, because at the end of the conch is a great big spike. But now, welcome to Debbie Winders, who's dressed for the weather. Hello, Debs. And the lovely Arthur, clad for summer. Shall we start this great contest, Arthur? Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Yes.
3, 2, 1.
One conch goes down. You burst the balloon, then he comes back to base, and the other conch takes over. That's the circuit, that's the crowd, everybody's excited. Let's have a cheer for Great Yarmouth. They burst the balloons with the spike on the end of the nose, and poor old Norwich haven't got one so far. Yes, they have. It's North Walsham. Norwich of two. North Walsham one. Great Yarmouth one. I love the monsters when they actually walk, when they toddle. Look at this, look at Great Yarmouth on the way there. Another one going in. Yes! But Norwich have four. Four for Norwich, three for Yarmouth. And four coming up for North. Here come Yarmouth again. Watch this. Let's wait. Bated breath. Cheer when he does it. He's hatching it out. Come on. Yes! But Norwich in the lead. And North Walsham. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great Yarmouth coming up there, fifth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes! Even Stevens now between Norwich and Great Yarmouth. Another one for Norwich, so what can Yarmouth do? Well, there's the setting with the little cheerleaders in full spate. Yarmouth are equal now, equal with Norwich, and you have to hurry. Can Norwich do this one? And so, release, yes, now the attack. The balloons suspended there from the balustrade. They've got to burst another six balloons. Yarmouth are in. Norwich are in. They knock forward. They head them down. Norwich are going to finish first, maybe. Yes, Norwich have got it. But what about Yarmouth? Yes, here they go. Come on. Come on, nod them in. Nod his. Yes. Get it in. There'll be a great cheer when you do. One of you do it. Yeah. Oh. This time. It's like waiting for the final whistle at Wembley. Come on, it's got to go because North Walsh. Hey, that's it. Well, in here we have the conks. Would you believe? Are you all right in there?
Yes.
Yes, he says.
Right, Arthur, yes, come to me.
And the winners, Norwich, in second place, Great Yarmouth, and in third place, North Walsham. And the points.
The points, before we do, let us welcome, on the lovely scoreboard, Helena Hunt. A little wave, blonde hair flying in the wind, and the points.
And the points. 3 points to Norwich.
Norwich, 3 points.
2 points to Great Yarmouth.
Great Yarmouth, 2 points.
1 point to North Walsham.
North Walsham, 1 point. Eddie with you on the marathon.
Well, the marathon is a football game. You've seen it, not this before, something similar. Dribbling along here, and then a net will appear. And that would have been in. That would have been 2 points. A marvellous actually been one. I'd like to see that justice is done. And you're all fit and ready. Maria to set it off. Ready? Well, there it is. Up they go for the first marathon. Let you know what it looks like. And it's between Norwich and Great Yarmouth. So every time Norwich kick in, you can cheer. Or if they miss it for Great Yarmouth, you can save it. Hard luck. So this is the game with the moving boat. Moving peddling, of course. Just one man in the second half. We'll have two men peddling to make it a lot more difficult. And we've got Linda Clement, we've got Steve Nodley, we've got an Eddie, we've got a William Black, and we've got a Kevin Denmark. And it's Norwich versus Great Yarmouth, Norwich kicking, Yarmouth moving the boat. So very important, the marathon, because it costs 6 points for the winner. And there, oh, hard luck. The lads are a bit handicapped. Hey, been eating too much Christmas pudding, but that apart, not his fault, decorated up very well. I think that was a sympathetic cheer, actually. Just one at the moment. How about two? So, it's a good job. He's got that belt on around the middle. And Pedaway starts pedaling again pretty fast, and there goes the whistle. And down he goes. And in comes Mike Swan. And this is the moment, declaration for the first team.
Yes, Norwich scored four.
Norwich scored four. And four goes up on the board. Well done, four. Half of the course is set. And back in the wet somewhere with Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. I am standing here, right here, with some Norwich supporters. You mean you're not Norwich supporters? Where are you from? Yarmouth. Well, quite by chance, would you believe, Great Yarmouth are going in this game. So, let me talk to you. Who is this young gentleman here?
Wayne.
Wayne, how old are you, Wayne?
Say three.
Three. Well, I'm going to tell you, because all the audience here, all the audience listening, well, I tell you what the game is. Because on top of that apparatus, said he with a quick peep at the script, we've got Carol Layton, haven't we? Give us a smile, Carol, and hold up your hosepipe, out of which should issue a lot of water. Have you got your hosepipe there? Show us your water. Oh, yeah, don't shower us with it. Well, apart from wetting us, she's going to wet two teammates at the bottom. They have a baby's bath. They've got to shin up the poles, get to the... Are you listening to me? Wayne, are you listening? Because... I always wanted to be a star. Never work with animals and children. So they come back with the baby's bath and they empty it into a measuring cylinder. Arthur, let us see what Great Yarmouth can do.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
I'll give him a cheer. Come on. They go to the top. And the one on the right is called Grizzly. Bedlam going on down here in the Arnica of the woods, but this is a good run. Carol sprays, down they come, they've got to hold it together. Yes, they've got a baffle. A big cheer when it goes in. To the top. Wearing household rubber gloves, they are. It's absolutely free. You're liberated to do what you like, aren't you, Arthur? So, Grizzly, as he's nicknamed, the man on the right, Paul Brown, and Don McDonough,
45 seconds.
Both of them specialists at the martial arts. How much longer to go, Arthur?
40 seconds now, but it's time to do it.
You're 40 seconds, lads, at the top. Come on, Grizzly, get over that bath.
Half a minute to go, you've plenty of time.
Arthur is whispering to you in those great Centaurian Halifax tones. Oh! Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. And I don't think we've time for another run. I don't think we've time for a run, and I think Is they were in a bit of a hurry. Yes, I think they've abandoned it, Arthur. Let's have a whistle blow. Right, just measure it.
And the score for Great Yarmouth is 4.5. Marks on the dipstick. 4.5.
Are you going metric on me?
No, it's that's the score. 4.5, or 4.5 if you want.
Four and a half in Halifax. So now we have team number two to have a go. At the top there for North Walsham, we've got Elaine Field, who's a TPO in the RAF. I don't know what a TPO is, but I'll find out later. And she is pouring water on Arthur's whistle.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
North Walsham in the shape of Ivor Field. From the RAF, on the right with the fair hair, the very fair hair, and the less fair hair is Rod Smith, who shouldn't be used to climbing poles because he's a Norfolk farmer. Four and a half to beat. The first run, obviously, is the vital one. All I can hear, the Yarmouth cheerleaders. Have I not got a cheer for North Walsham? But a good run, and they take care. 1 minute to go. They sort out the tin bath. Ivor and Rod. Yes, they're going to make a second run. We'll watch the clock. The strain is beginning to tell up there. Half a minute to go, chaps. And a good run. Yes, they're taking the time, they're crossing their legs around the pole. This could be critical. All of it must go in. They spill the drop. I think they're going to have another go. How long got to go? How much longer, Arthur? 10 seconds. I wouldn't be bothering, lads, at 10 seconds. There goes the whistle, and Arthur comes forward.
And the score for North Walsham, 13.5 marks on the dipstick.
13 and a half marks on the dipstick for North Walsham. And now we have the Norwich team. Let's go, Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Give the Norwich lads a cheer. Come on over there, I know where you are. Two runs it's got to be. Two runs to beat 13 and a half for North Walsham. Full bath would help a lot on this first run. No, they're playing tactics that elected for half a bath. Half a bath, is that good enough? I'm going to ask Debbie if it's good enough.
We've got another minute to go, so I don't know.
The tactics could pay. Debbie Winders herself, a very famous knockout competitor. Now, one of our lovely scorers. I will just have a look at that. I don't think it was enough. It's 5 marks. 5 marks, you want 8.5 to draw level with North Walsham, and you need more, Susan. You need more in that bath than you put in on the first round. First of all, get the bath across. Swing it.
20 seconds.
Come on, 20 seconds and we're getting excited for you. 20 seconds, come on, lads. Give them a cheer to help them on their way. It's tough at the top. Come on. Come on, lads, we're with you. Come on, Oh, dear. The face here. A face of disappointment. There it is, a disappointed lad. You couldn't hang on, could you? You couldn't quite hang on, eh? Right, Arthur.
And the score for Norwich, 5 marks on the dipstick. So the result, North Walsham are the winners. In second place, Norwich. And in third place, Great Yarmouth. And the points?
Yes!
3 points to North Walsham.
North Walsham, 3 points.
2 points to Norwich.
2 points to Norwich.
And 1 point to Great Yarmouth.
1 point to Great Yarmouth. The scores then, Norwich 5, North Walsham 4, Great Yarmouth 3, and Eddie with you.
Well, the second round, North Walsham against Norwich. Away we go. Crikey. Well, this is Keith Fraser, who got off pretty well off the mark, actually. A bank official get all sorts in this competition. One's a welder here, one's a bank manager, one's an insurance clerk. Ah, the chairs are... Is that one or two? Did that one come out? It's two. Now, you see, they're getting tactics. They're throwing the ball well up, hard luck, just outside the upright. Henry Batchelor and Elizabeth. Well, it's just on the right there is Elizabeth Wrighton, insurance clerk, pushing and showing. She's a hockey player, if you're, I'm sure, a family are interested. Chasing four, which was the first one. And it's North Walsham. Four on the master scoreboard. Hard luck. Hey, I know it's the post again, but that'll get you nowhere. It won't get you anywhere in the league table. Put a bit of spin on it. A Stanley Matthews dribble. Oh, beautiful. Now that, oh, hard luck. Well, you certainly deserve more than, I don't know how many they've got, actually, but, sure. We shall learn in due course. Bit, no. It's a bit tricky with the rain. It's a bit troublesome, and I'm sure it's not far off. And it came, did the whistle. So we shall get a full report any moment. A four already. North Walsham, how many, Mr. Swan?
North Walsham scored three.
Three? 4-3, so it's getting very tight. Right. Meanwhile, Stuart.
Well, there's the next game. It's called the drum roll. As you see, all three teams will go. And I'm standing next to a lovely girl here called Jane. Her partner, Paul, is in there. And you'll see the game because inside the big drum is a little drum on which they have to balance and roll along. And as I speak, I feel a little drizzle of rain, despite the temperature of 90 Fahrenheit. Now, Jane, what on earth's happened to the weather here?
I don't know. It's not as nice as North Walsham.
Oh, hello, a little dialogue, a little commercial for North Walsham. What's North Walsham famous for, then, my love?
Nelson, going to the grammar school. The grammar school, he used to go there.
He used to go there?
Yeah.
And beach, is it a fishing village as well?
No, not really, no.
Not really. Do clever people come from there, Paul? Paul, do clever people?
Yeah.
Yes? Very clever. We'll see how sharp they are from North Walsham. Boasting like that, as Arthur blows his whistle and the three teams will then blitz down the course.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Well, let's see how smart North Walsham can be. Well, they're in the lead. They're in the orange one, if you're watching in colour, on the left-hand side of the screen. That's North Walsham in the lead. In the middle, we've got Norwich. On the far side, we have Great Yarmouth. Yes, that's the Yarmouth one. The Yarmouth in the bright orange. In the yellow, we have North Walsham. And, of course, they're living up to what they said they would do. Paul and Jane, they said they were smart. That's Jane, you can see. In the blue, that's with her little fingers on the outside of the drum, and Jane is a shop assistant. Very keen cross-country runner. On the other side, Paul works for an oil company. But they're streets ahead of the opposition, North Walsham. Coming up on the inside, fast, we have Norwich. But Great Yarmouth are making a recovery. Give them a cheer. Give Yarmouth a cheer. They're making a recovery. Past the banks of cheerleaders. That's Norwich. And in the background, the tiniest cheerleaders I've ever seen. In the middle there, in the green, there's some really tiny tots. Really emoting. That's them. Norwich coming forward, that fine cathedral city. Beautiful place, a fine old city. View it from whatever side you will, George Borrow said, of early 19th century Norwich. And the same hold true today. And Norwich are in second place, but coming home now, that's it. That's North Walsham crossing the finishing line now. The cheers ring out. Norwich will finish in second place. Smiles from Paul and Jane. Norwich will finish in second. That's Norwich. Smartly attired in the white t-shirts, in the green shorts. Miss Windus walking behind. Norwich are finishing now. And the whistle is blown on it. Well, come in. You said they were clever, and you were. Congratulations. Well done. Arthur, come on from the right.
The winners, North Walsham, in second place, Norwich, and in third place, Great Yarmouth. And the points.
Yeah.
The points, 3 points to North Walsham.
3 points to North Walsham.
2 points to Norwich.
2 points to Norwich.
And 1 point to Great Yarmouth.
One for Yarmouth, keep taking the Shakespeare. And at the moment, Norwich 7, North Walsham 7, Great Yarmouth 4, and that lovely actor, Eddie Waring.
Thank you very much, Stuart. And the last of the marathons, the first round, Great Yarmouth versus North Walsham, chasing a 4, chasing a 3. And the bugle goes. And it's going Denmark. Luck. Kevin Pino, Henry Batchelor, and the young lady is a Dawn Brown. She's a teacher, and he's got a little overweight. That will get him nowhere. The idea is to go into the net, boys. Won't get anything for that. 4 and a 3 to beat. Yeah, no. Yeah. Well, how unlucky can you be? Great Yarmouth kicking. Anybody from Great Yarmouth? Thank you. And North Walsham. Anybody from North Walsham? Good. Enjoy yourselves. Well done. One in. Throwing it in. A little bit of tactics, but of course, the move in vault sends it back. Once they get off that, it's impossible to vault it in. Tactics, you can see him throwing it up. It's in two, I think. Unless one's come out and nobody told me. Don't have to. Oh, yeah, beauty. Ah, beauty. Well, that was very good, but I don't think that it's going to, well, anyway, it's not going to be thinking, what, we've got a 4 and a 3. How many have we got for the hometown team, Great Yarmouth?
Great Yarmouth scored 3.
Great Yarmouth scored 3, and somebody's happy. Back to Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. Have your hats? My boater's gone. Bring me boater back. Thank you very much, because I'm with some little Norwich boys and girls, aren't I? Whereabouts in Norwich are you from? Where do you live?
Supposed to Norfolk.
Oh, I see. And who are you cheering for then, Norwich?
Yes.
Oh, very, very quiet though today. Are you quite pleased with conditions? But something's gone wrong. What's happened to the weather? Is it always like this?
No.
No? Sometimes hot and sunny, is it? Smashing. Right. In the meanwhile, wait for this, because Yarmouth being a great resort and fishing village, we're going to play a sort of boating game with a difference. Because this is the knockout boat here. It's not a board, it's a boat. Can you imagine? It's a boat. Say yes, right, and I'm going over to it now. And here are the rowers, not at the side, but underneath. Good. The Norwich stalwarts are underneath, and let us welcome aboard Miss Hazel Bull. Aboard your barge, madam. Right, so they're in contention there, the two teams. They go down the course, and you'll see how it unfolds. They're taking the strain. Let it rip, Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Hazel Bull aboard the Norwich boat. Aboard North Walsham, we've got Sheila Olive. North Walsham in the blue, Norwich in the white. And you see how they roll our knockout boat along. They progress down the course, passing the boat with the girl on top. And then the man at the back runs to the front. And as you see, there's nothing in it, it's neck and neck. There's absolutely nothing in it, they've done one hurdle, there's another hurdle to go. This is it, the knockout boat race. Plenty of excitement in the crowd. Do I hear a cheer for North Walsham? Do I hear one? And what about Norwich? Do I hear Norwich cheers?
Yes.
The Norwich cheerleaders are emoting. At stake, of course, today is a trip to beautiful Yugoslavia. The winners go south of the Danube to an almost unpronounceable town in Yugoslavia. We'll have a go at it later in the programme, but not now. Norwich are coming up to win. They've got to get the boat, the rowers, and the coxswain. Norwich have won it, yes! Let them finish, Arthur, let them finish. Whoops-a-daisy, yes. Right. Where's Arthur? Is he behind me? Up he comes.
Yes. Norwich are the winners. 3 points to Norwich.
3 points to Norwich.
2 points to North Walsham.
2 points to North Walsham, and you'll see from the scoreboard, no jokers played, but Norwich 10, North Walsham 9, Great Yarmouth 4, and on to our next game. Well, now do I have a little cheer for Martin Moss, 17-year-old schoolboy of Great Yarmouth. We'll make you famous. And on the other side, we have Paul of North Walsham. And on the whistle, they grab a wire above their head and suspended from the wire, they have to paddle this great disc down the course. This is a game that demands steely nerves, stamina, and enterprise, and I hope you've got all three. Meanwhile, I see the North Walsham Joker coming in, the first of the afternoon. And who's it being played by? What is your name, my love?
Deborah Taylor.
Deborah Taylor. How old are you?
11.
11. And what is this mascot? You can turn round because, Mum, no, the cameras are over there. That's your lovely face. Okay, what is the mascot about? What's the mascot?
Smurfy.
Who?
Smurfy.
Smurfy. Is he special? Is he special to North Walsham? Is he? Is he very special? Does he bring you luck? Yes, right. Okay, let's see. Let's put them out of their misery or joy, whatever.
Yes, ready. 3, 2, 1.
Well, already North Walsham have taken a slight lead. And he's guiding it with one foot and perched on top with the other. That is Paul Brown. Paul in the blue. If he drops it, the teammate can come forward and help him. Both teams at the moment stranded, no movement. But can Martin Moss beat Paul Brown? There are the legs, there's the physique, there are the mighty muscles. And he's got some muscles too. Look at those biceps, crumbs. But he's going to win. He's going to win for North Walsham. The Joker's safe, there it is, he's won it. He's won it and Martin comes off. And Arthur, well, well, well. A bit of trickery with the foot there. Did you see it, Arthur? Yes, it was on the top there, and a bit of the old Halifax up and under.
Right. Well, North Walsham were the winners, surprisingly, a time of 55 seconds. 3 points to North Walsham. They played the Joker, doubling up to six. 6 points to North Walsham.
6 points to North Walsham. Helena on the scoreboard.
And 2 points to Great Yarmouth.
2 points to Great Yarmouth. That opens a fair old gap because North Walsham in the lead with 15 points. Norwich have 10. Great Yarmouth have 6. And on to our next merry joust. Well, who have I got here? North Walsham supporters? Yarmouth. Yarmouth. The ice cream looks delicious. Marvellous. Right. Yes, you can't beat it. But in the middle, by the way, going for North Walsham. Have we got anybody from North Walsham? There they are. Good stout people. Here we have the North Walsham team about to take off, and they've got 10 bricks here. They have to transport them down the course, going as they do through two Chinese puzzles, little bits of hurdles with elastic in them, and then at the far end you have a podium. The game finishes when all the bricks are on the podium with the teams. Tell me something about this North Walsham team, because you're a bit of a dark horse at the moment. How did you pick your squad in North Walsham?
Well, we chose about 30, 35 to start with and whittled them down from there.
And what professions or trades do they come from, your team?
All sorts. Teachers, Shop assistants, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Clerical assistants.
And what about the training? How arduous was the training?
Very, very arduous. Very, very arduous.
Commando stuff?
Definitely, definitely.
Well, you've shown you've got mighty muscles. By gum, you didn't half rip off that joker in fine style. So what do you think the time is going to be for this game? Give us some a target to aim for. Let's talk to one of the girls. The time to aim for, my lovely.
Oh, I should think about 12 seconds.
12? You wouldn't like to bet on that. 12 seconds. Right, Arthur. Let us blow the whistle. Flex the muscles and away you go.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
So they keep the blocks together. The idea is the two fellas on the end. They're important because they've got to push like the strength of Garth, and the girls have got to keep the whole ensemble together. Oh, and that... Those ropes catch them. Oh! Well, flipping heck. They have to push on the ends through the puzzle, and those ropes don't half get you in a funny position, don't they? But they go, knockout competitors go through hell and high water for the sake of going abroad to represent their city, the town, the village. And the game finishes when they're all on. When they all get on, it's finished. One more, jump aboard. The applause rings out. Yes. And they're up aloft. But it wasn't. It wasn't 12 seconds, Arturo, was it?
No, it was 1 minute 18 seconds.
That's the bogey time, 1 minute 18 seconds. Yes. And now, at the far end, we have Norwich. And... Ready, yes? Norwich to go, Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
And we'll watch it from this end. With all the cheerleaders who are absolutely burning in the heat. God, this heat. Not an umbrella in sight. The Norwich cheerleaders going through a lovely routine. And the boys and girls of this Norwich side. Let's have a look at the clock, Arthur. What is the clock time?
The clock at the moment, 40 seconds.
40 seconds. And they're making mincemeat of our game. Well in with limit time. You're beating the clock. All over, everybody on. The Norwich team bombing, still to play the joker, and it's there. Congratulations, you stalwarts. Well done. Humphrey, the time.
Yes, and the time for Norwich, 57 seconds.
Oh, 50 seconds. 57 seconds. There is the great Yarmouth team poised to break records. Arthur,
ready? 3, 2, 1.
57 seconds is the bogey time. The important factor in the game is the pressure at both ends of the column. Do I have a cheer for Great Yarmouth? Oh. Yes, I can hear you. Let's keep an eye on the clock. Arthur, the clock, the clock, the clock. 40 seconds.
40 seconds.
Yes. 40 seconds. You're well up with the clock. Up with it. You've got to cross the line. Cross the line. On the line. Get aboard now. Get aboard. Get aboard. Come on, you're up with the clock. Faster, 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 faster. Everybody on. Yes. Well, the excitement. Suddenly the tumult is stilled. Waiting for your pronouncement.
Yes. Great Yarmouth, exactly the same time. 57 seconds.
And so
the winners, a joint winners, Norwich and Great Yarmouth. 3 points to Great Yarmouth.
3 points to Great Yarmouth, and welcome two for the home team.
3 points to Norwich.
3 points to Norwich.
And 1 point to North Walsham.
1 point to North Walsham. Now the competition is really joined. North Walsham 16, Norwich 13, Great Yarmouth 9. Once again, Ed, it's with you.
And we start the second round of the marathon. It's Norwich versus North Walsham. Who's going to go in front? 4-3-3, very close. Please. I'm sure they heard that. And off we go. Very important points in the marathon. But you, one difference, which I'll explain in one moment. There comes the net across. Hard lines. There are two peddlers. There they are off. And the girl, there are peddlers. Steady up, like a 6-day bike ride. Going steady and then bolting around the corners. Give the names. Michael Barrett of Norwich. William Black of Norwich. Keith Fraser of North Walsham. Henry Batchelor of North Walsham. And the girl, Linda Clements of Norwich. So there's the team, and you did that well, son. You get nothing for it, but you did it well. Yes, yes, yep. You want to go up more off the inside foot. Use your instep. It's a bit tricky with the right hard line. It's amazing the number. There you are. There you are. Now then. It's very hard to once you're down, it takes a bit of getting up. Oh yes, yes. So Norwich, who got four and leading on the first half against the 3-3, very close actually. Impossible to tell at this. Oh. Well, he took that for a right bolter, skidded. And went for a bird, but I think he's all right. In fact, I'm sure he's all right. The main thing is, what's the score?
Well, that time, Norwich scored 3, making their total 7.
7! So that's par for the course of the second half.
That's right.
All right, thank you very much, Hunter Stewart.
Your microphone is served, sir.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Cookie, the voice I know and love of Martin Moss of Great Yarmouth. There are two Great Yarmouth cookies here, and as you can see, they're holding the great big trifles you'd all love to throw at one another, wouldn't you?
Yes, you would.
Along the line, we've got some more cookies here from each of the other teams, with Norwich here on the end, North Walsham, and I see the Great Yarmouth Joker being played. Well then, let me turn you round, young sir, and tell me what be your name.
Robin.
Robin what?
Shorthouse.
Robin Shorthouse, and you live in Great Yarmouth?
No.
Where do you live?
Ormsby.
Ecky Thump, where's that? Is it far away?
6 miles.
6 miles. And how old are you?
Six.
Six, and he's got one heck of a lisp anyway, that's for sure. Well, we're going to wish you the very best of luck. Let us shake hands, because we're all friends in It's a Knockout. And behind you, what is this?
A big stick of Yarmouth Rock.
A big stick of Yarmouth Rock. What a great big voice you have. And who's it for?
Stuart Hall.
Stuart Hall. Oh, whoopee, I've got a prezzy. Oh, thank you very much indeed. Thank you. What a delightful little prezzy that is. Well, I wish you the best of luck. And, of course, the other two teams as well, Arthur. Let's be fair. Thank you. Watch Arthur. Stay here and watch him blow his whistle. It's dramatic. He summons all his strength up. He summons his strength. Now, then, go on.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
To orbit they go. Young Paul, you'll enjoy this game, that's for sure. Over the derby. And a face full of bloody trifle. Well, it's a strange game on which to play the Joker for Yarmouth, but nevertheless, that's what they've risked it on. That's Norwich. Norwich have got one. I want to cheer every time a trifle goes on. Norwich 1. North Walsham 1. Well, Yarmouth, that's North Walsham. But on the other side, North, Yarmouth are really in trouble. They can't quite get it together. But they are not yet. Great Yarmouth coming in for one. Give it a cheer. Great Yarmouth one. And the... They are well bogged down. Great Yarmouth are coming in the meanwhile for two. They've all got two, North Walsham two and Norwich two. One of them lost a boot. It's not the only thing they'll lose, I'm sure. Rolling about the goal. Come on, let's have some more jellies. North Walsham, that is, in the middle. Oh, dear. And the expression, of course, never changes on the dummies. Who is that? North Walsham. With a face full of trifle. And that is the wasteland. This ground will never be the same again. It's the home of the Great Yarmouth football team, or apparently a super team. But with plenty of jellies and trifles and wounded cookies around. And in we go. Let's have a look at... Look at this. A stranded cookie. How about this? Are we all right in there?
I don't know how you are.
He's all right. He's still alive. We'll tell you whether you've won or not. Arthur, let's advance and be recognised.
Right. And the final score, North Walsham delivered four trays.
Four big trifles.
Norwich delivered four.
Four.
Great Yarmouth only delivered three.
Oh, they've blown the joker.
And so the points, 3 points to North Walsham.
3 points to North Walsham.
3 points to Norwich.
3 points to Norwich.
1 point to Great Yarmouth. They played the joker, doubled it up to two. 2 points to Great Yarmouth.
2 points to Great Yarmouth. So in the lead still, North Walsham 19, Norwich 16, Great Yarmouth 11, and blown the joker. But Eddie with you.
Well, I go with Mickey Fraser. He's one of the star men of the North Walsham team going next. Bank official.
Yes, I've just recently moved down to Great Yarmouth, so in fact I'm playing for the wrong team.
They tried to transfer you, did they?
They did. They succeeded, in fact.
And how long have you been training to get into this competition?
It's roughly about 3 months, I'd have thought. It might have been a bit longer.
You're going to win?
I hope so.
Off you go, because you're on next. Ready? Everybody's there, all set. Right. Thank you, and away they go. Keith Fraser, I've talked to you about Elizabeth. Right, then. Henry Batchelor, and for Yarmouth, Kevin Denmark. So there's the boys of North. Chasing a seven, they want four to be. It got two, so that's five. Unless one's gone in that I didn't notice, one's come out, but I don't think that matters. Two pedals, North Walsham against Great Yarmouth, and got plenty of supporters. Let's hear from them. And they're giving them encouragement. Hard lines, Keith's going to make himself a permanent place at Yarmouth if they win this one. Great rivalry here. A lot of enthusiastic supporters for all teams. Well, I don't know what about that. I suppose he did. Anyway, I'm not the judge, thank goodness. Nice. North Walsham. Great Yarmouth, and they're going in nicely. Seven. The best so far. In Norwich. Right over. Now, how can you do it? I think that interview has got him really going. Been training for over 3 months. And training very rigorously. getting themselves fit, and there the bus be soon for the whistle to... Oh, that was a bit of a bad shot. You must have been tired there. I think he got tired then because he started to run and then came back and got nowhere, and you've come.
Well, that's right. North Walsham scored 10. The last one didn't count because it was out of time. Yes. Because it was out of time. So their total is 13.
Well, that's good news. Good. 13. Well, lucky or unlucky. Time will tell, Stuart.
Well, here I've got some very happy, smiling young faces. What do you call?
Emma.
Emma, how old?
8.
And?
Melissa.
How old?
9.
And?
Lynn.
How old?
11.
11? You're getting past it. Well, so what about all this get-up? Are you dancers?
We're gymnasts.
You're gymnasts, are you? Well, I'll tell you what. Put these little wrappers down, and shall we see if she can do a handstand? Yeah. Shall we? Yeah. Go on, Emma, you're challenged to it. Let's see how you do it. And she held it for about 2 seconds. Now then, Jane, what about you? Come on, these are the old Corbetts of the future, all from Norwich. Go on, let's see how you can... Oh! Now then, let's have the professional. There has been at 11. What, boys? Hey, I hope the teacher wasn't watching all that. Anyway, you're all set now to do into a lightning routine, because on this game here, you've got two big boys on the ramp there, two equally handsome huskies from Great Yarmouth, and they suspend themselves from the wires up at the top. Are you listening to me? Or pay attention, just because you've been a television star. And they dangle from the wires, and they have to burst the balloons as they go down the course. It's a game for very, very strong men. But now, can I have a little cheer, because the Norwich Joker is being played. It's like a schoolgirls' hockey match at Wembley. Okay, let's have the Norwich Joker, because it's Fuzzy Bear. What is the mascot for Norwich?
His name is Terrific.
Who?
Terrific.
Terrific. Terrific Bear. Yeah. Terrific Norwich. Well, the very best of luck. We wish everybody playing Jokers the very, very best. Arthur, ready?
Yes, ready. 3, 2, 1.
One for Norwich. The cheerleaders are going into their routine, and Norwich are bombing the course. Empty thump. They are on their way. They've 4 to go. Yarmouth trailing by 1. The two big strong boys, he can't start until your teammates had enough. Go back and start again. Come on. Yarmouth have 4 to burst. 3 now. Norwich are down. This could be critical. This could blow off the Norwich Joker. If Yarmouth could come up now on the rails, they have. Well, Yarmouth could suddenly come. Yarmouth could be in the lead now. They are. Well, a hero's performance here for Yarmouth. Incredible. The world fancy, but now then, what could Yarmouth do? A great performance by these two boys. Norwich are tiring. Well, let's hear some Yarmouth cheers then. Yarmouth are coming in for this balloon for the match. Incredible. Come here. You must give the boy a cheer. Come on. They came from nowhere. And not only burst the balloons, but burst the Norwich Joker too.
That's true. Now, I want to explain the reason why I sent the Norwich man back to the podium. He started to cross the wire before the other man had come off. So that's the reason he was sent back. The final score.
Oh, you've decided, have you?
Great Yarmouth scored 7. Norwich scored 6. 3 points to Great Yarmouth.
Great Yarmouth, 3 points. And they need them.
And Norwich scored two, but they play the joker, double it up to four. 4 points to Norwich.
4 points to Norwich, the competition then. 20 for Norwich, 19 for North Walsham, and 14 for Great Yarmouth for the last marathon of the day, Eddie.
And it's Great Yarmouth against Norwich for the last and very important marathon. Right, Maria, off you go to start it. And away they go. Very important. Chasing a 13, which is the lead at the moment, North Walsham. So they want 11 to win. Can they do it? 1 minute and a half. Add luck. Very important to the 6 points for the marathon might make all the difference to this very interesting competition with a great crowd despite the weather. Tremendous enthusiasm. Come on, that the boys are cheering. So for Yarmouth, John Brown, Kevin Denmark, Kevin Harwell, and the boys who say they're the most important one are the peddlers for Norwich. There they are, Stephen Dudley and Trevor Richardson, 17 and 18, and said, we are the two lads that will stop them winning. Now they're going in four, getting closer, getting warmer, more exciting. Is it? I don't know. Oh, beautiful. Hard luck. Looking good at the moment, but a lot to beat after that. Hard luck. Svenny goes for that slip down and almost nearly blasts it. Tickles them. Time is the first time, I don't know, but not a lot of time left. Got to be chasing it. Mike Swan looking at his watch. If it's a calendar off course there, I don't know what would have happened. He goes the whistle. Well, it was a very good do, Great Yarmouth, whatever it was. It was a tremendous effort, and I don't know, but I will very soon, so will you.
Yes, Great Yarmouth scored 8, making a total of 11.
Ah, well, 11. So, with the money, we now go to the master scoreboard, and we've got 6 points for North Walsham. Four points for Great Yarmouth. And 2 points for Norwich. And thank you very much. And so it's all up and on to the last game with Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. There aloft is our knockout banner. And as you come down, you'll see the familiar faces of this afternoon's gladiators snarling behind the ropes as they ache to come across with the footballs. You've seen the game before on the dirigible into the containers in front of us. So, Arthur, let us start them on their merry way.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Four boys of the three teams. North Walsham came from nowhere in the marathon, and Norwich blew their joker, and it could be very, very costly. At the moment, Great Yarmouth 2, Norwich 2, North Walsham 2. The North Walsham cheerleaders in the background, in full spate. It's the boys covered in foam. North Walsham leading, 4. They are determined to go to Yugoslavia. 4 for North Walsham, 4 for Norwich, 5 for Great Yarmouth. If North Walsham win, that'll put them 28 points. If Norwich win, 25. But nothing can stop North Walsham. They are going to Yugoslavia. All we're playing for now is pride. I shall sneak to our referees, adjudicating. And I'm going to ask Arthur, who is in the lead.
1 minute to go. 1 minute.
1 minute ago, who's in the lead?
Aspen were in the game, Joe.
Right, I'm counting now for Debbie Windus. How many were Norwich in the middle?
I don't know, it looks very close.
Nobody knows anything. Well, I'll do the counting for you. Yarmouth, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Norwich, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But North Walsham, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. One fell off. Mike Swan says, put it back on. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 for North Walsham, but Norwich in the lead. It could have been close if only Norwich and Great Yarmouth hadn't have blown their jokers. It could have been a closer contest. And the whistle blows on it. The abominable snowmen creep away.
And the final score for this game, Great Yarmouth scored 15.
Great Yarmouth, 15.
North Walsham, 13.
North Walsham, 13.
And Norwich, 12.
And Norwich, 12. The points?
The points. 3 points to Great Yarmouth.
3 points to Great Yarmouth.
2 points to North Walsham.
2 points to North Walsham.
1 point to Norwich.
1 point to Norwich. And therefore, North Walsham supporters, the winners with 27 points. At the scoreboard in jubilate is Eddie.
Well, what a very interesting... Thank you very much, Alina. You did a great job. Let me congratulate the mayor, Mrs. Millington. Well done. Your team were marvellous. You enjoyed it.
They were wonderful. I'm very proud of them.
Very good. We've got something for you to remember us by, a very special plaque. We hope it'll find a nice place for you. Thanks for being in the competition. And for the details where everybody goes and doesn't go, Stuart. Best up, as always.
Thank you, with the yellow one. Right, yes, North Walsham get on the board. And let's run down it now. Aaron go to Ascona in Switzerland. Henley on Thames go to Saint-Gaudens in France. North Walsham go to Doni Milanovac in Yugoslavia. And it's a championship knockout from Arena North, Charlotte Richard, next week. Another mighty extravaganza from Lambeth, starring Kingston upon Thames versus Hounslow versus Lambeth. And for the final words from Uncle Eddie.
Hope you've enjoyed it from us all. Good night, God bless. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, everybody. Bye.